Alright, what's happening, y'all? It's your boy Rico from Street Scores coming with another Rico Report. Main topics today, a lot of changes to the Washington football team organization and franchise, a lot of new hires, promotions, all kinds of stuff. Also, I want to break down this fan engagement from the Fan Ambassador Network and like all of the different areas that they're going to cover, how many members per area and what they do. Also, a few snubs from a couple of lists. We're going to talk about those and much more. And before we get into this video, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Hit the bell next to the subscription button so you get a notification immediately. And every time I release an informative and opinionated video just like this one, make sure you check out the rest of the channel. Have all of my videos organized in playlists. I even have a comedy playlist for all of my funny videos. So make sure you go check out the rest of the channel and stay tuned for all of the content I'm coming out with. And without further ado, let's get it. Alright, so first of all, big news. The Washington football team has announced that Tanya Snyder, the wife of Daniel Snyder, has been named co-CEO. She will join her husband as the Washington football team looks forward to unveiling a new name and brand for the next era of Washington football. Also, Mrs. Snyder is now one of the few female CEOs in NFL history. And you can go and check out my video where I broke down how the Washington football team is breaking all kinds of barriers with various minority hires, whether it be by race or gender, putting minorities in places with great power and responsibility. So I love it. And this just only adds to it. And it's not like Tanya Snyder's coming out of nowhere, because that may be some people's first reactions, like why would you hire your wife and stuff like that. But she has a proven record of really helping this organization. She has literally led the Washington football team's philanthropic activities for years now. And over the past year, she's become more involved in the team's daily operations. For the last two decades, Tanya Snyder has led the team's charitable foundation, which has raised $29 million for the Washington, D.C. metro area. She also founded the team's Women of Washington fan club that now includes 135,000 female fans. And in 1999, when Daniel Snyder bought the team, she helped launch the Think Pink campaign for breast cancer awareness, a disease that she fought nearly a decade later. And with all of the changes going on throughout the front office, the coaching staff, and things like that, both the team and the NFL have began to refer to Tanya Snyder for a lot of decisions. She's been very key on a lot of the team's decision making. And again, both the team and the NFL have referred to her for various questions, topics, concerns, and things like that. So she's had a prominent role for a while now amongst his organization, but now she has like an official title. And that's cool to see her step up when all of this confusion was going on, with Ron Rivera being brought in as the head coach, Jason Wright being brought in as the team president, and all of these changes going from Jay Gruden and Bruce Allen to Ron Rivera and Jason Wright. Again, I broke down a lot of the big changes that have happened to the team since Ron Rivera has been here in that video I was talking about earlier. But I mean, even like the head of training staff, the scouts, I mean, everything is different from top to bottom. And that's dope for Tanya Snyder to step up big whenever people have had questions and concerns, because she's one of the very few pieces of continuity in this franchise. And Dan Snyder even had a quote. He said, "Tanya has always been my closest confidant and most important advisor, but her role has outgrown such informal titles. The perspective she brings to this organization is invaluable, and I am incredibly proud to recognize it with a fitting title, CEO." So he's proud of his wife, man. I love it. Hopefully she can keep him in check. Hopefully her having an official title and being around the organization more can keep him in check so that we can keep the Dan Snyder that we've had the past couple of years and not revert back to the old Dan Snyder, which is one of the worst owners in NFL history. These past 2 years, he's actually been a good owner. Been pretty much doing everything right and nothing wrong. No micromanaging, delegating responsibilities to who's best for those certain topics and discussions and areas of expertise. So keep up the good work, Dan Snyder. And Tanya Snyder, stay on his head. Also, Ryan Vermillion, the Washington football team's head athletic trainer, is now listed on the Washington football team's website as director of sports medicine and head athletic trainer. And of course, you know, Ryan Vermillion followed Ron Rivera to Washington last year after 18 seasons with the Carolina Panthers. I mean, he was there working for the Carolina Panthers as the head athletic trainer longer than Ron Rivera was a head coach. And then Ron Rivera brought him over to the Washington football team along with a lot of ex-Panthers front office and coaching members. Also, some recent and unannounced hires. Shouts out to Nikki Javala for providing this information. Drew Hampton was hired as the head equipment manager. He replaces Anders Battelle. Jeff Ruiz is now hired as the physical therapist. And Ashley Kors is now hired as the player personnel assistant. Also, as I alluded to in the beginning of this video before the intro, the Washington football team has announced the launch of FAN, the team's first ever Fan Ambassador Network. That's what FAN stands for, Fan Ambassador Network. It's comprised of a diverse group of 40 Washington football team supporters from across the DMV and the country. FAN will serve as the voice of the fan base as the organization works to reimagine and enhance its game day experience. So it's not even just like the brand name, like the logo, the name. It's also like the experience around the stadium, tailgating in the stadium, the food and things like that. Ron Rivera gave a quote. He said, especially after last season, it's imperative that we bring our fans back together. Basically alluding to the pandemic and how crazy everything was with fans barely being there. I think fans were only able to attend like two games and then it was like a very limited amount. He went on to say, we need to do it the right way. The creation of the Fan Ambassador Network is a fantastic way for us to bring our passionate fans further into the organization. I've had the personal pleasure of speaking with several fan members already, and I love the excitement they have to be part of this group, and I can't wait to see the positive impact they will have on our game day experience at FedEx Field. And I'm assuming the president, Jason Wright, with his PR and marketing background, if he wasn't the creator of this network, the founder of this network, he definitely played a large role in it. And shouts out to Dan Snyder, Jason Wright, and whoever was a part of the creation of this, because this is really dope that fans will have a voice in what goes on with the team on and off the field, mostly off the field, but in the stadium. Nominated by family, friends, colleagues, and fellow Washington football team fans, and selected from more than 1,300 nominations, the Fan Ambassador Network is comprised of 7 planning groups. The first one, community, 7 members. They're here to help define the team's presence throughout the DMV. Next up, culinary, that would be 5 members, to share thoughts on in-stadium and tailgate event food and beverages. Culture, that's 4 members, to give insights on local art and lifestyle as well as team history. Next up is entertainment, 7 members, to provide ideas around integrating areas like music, dance, and gaming. The team is a DC team, so I'm pretty sure Go-Go may be involved. You know how the Washington football team is one of the last teams with a live band. I like that. So I'm pretty sure that's gonna play a part in it. I mean, gaming is really interesting as well. Then fashion, that's 4 members, to discuss opinions on merchandise and new gear. That's really interesting. I feel like that may be the thing I would be the best involved in if I could have been a part of it. Cause like anything dealing with DMV, with me being from Atlanta, I don't feel like I could be an expert over a lot of y'all who are from the DMV. I feel like that would be very arrogant for me to just assume that I can be. Like, I know Go-Go exists, but I can't go deep into his history like y'all can, who were born and raised there, have gone to Go-Go concerts and things like that. So I wouldn't even dare overstep my welcome like that. But hey, fashion, man, I got you. I could do a little something with that. And maybe I could do something with tailgating food and beverages, but I don't even like grilled foods. Like, I don't even like grill marks on food, like hot dogs, burgers, when it's burnt. To me, it just tastes like charcoal and fire. I don't understand why anybody likes it, but hey. So I probably just already X'd myself out of that one. Then the family experience, 7 members, to help create game day activities that are enjoyable for both parents and kids. Oh yeah, I could do that too. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I could definitely do that. I always get the Rico love the kids from my friends and stuff like that. So I could definitely do that. Then Sunday Fun Day, 6 members, to represent the crowd looking to take advantage of every minute of their weekend while also safely rooting on the team. That sounds pretty interesting. That group is a little bit more ambiguous, but I kind of get what they're trying to say. I think they want to make sure that there's a dedicated 6 people that's going to root the loudest, make sure everything is fun, and make sure everything is good-hearted and competitive, not just people fighting and things like that. It could be like friendly trash talking and things like that. Sounds pretty interesting. Fan representatives were selected by a panel led by Vice President of guest experience at Washington football team, Joey Kobe Begovich, and Doug Williams, senior advisor to Washington football team, Jason Wright. Okay, so these are all of the people that were involved. Each member of FAN was notified on their selection via a recorded message from Coach Ron Rivera. That's dope. Seven fan members impressed the team so much that they were chosen to serve as the leaders of their respective planning groups and were notified of this honor via a surprise personal call from Coach Ron Rivera over Zoom. These leaders will have the opportunity to work directly with members on the Washington football team staff on topics related to their planning group. So this is really dope. I like this. I saw that NBC News anchor Craig Melvin, who's a lifelong fan of the Washington football team, will be a member of the Washington Fan Ambassador Group. So that's dope that they're bringing in a lot of notable people as well. And they're making sure that it's true fans of the team. It's people that bleed burgundy and gold. Doesn't matter if you're the news anchor for NBC, if you're the local landscape guy like me, as long as you bleed burgundy and gold, you meet the criteria. And that's dope. Next up, Travis Kelce, George Kittle, and Greg Olsen held a tight end university type of thing. When I hear tight end U, I mostly think of like when colleges talk trash to each other and they're like, no, I'm tight end U. We've had the best tight ends come through our program in football history and things like that. So that caught me a little off guard when I first heard it. But I mean, that's still a pretty nice title for that. Like, it makes sense. Tight end university, everybody's going there to learn how to play tight end. They brought in over 40 NFL tight ends. Logan Thomas was one of them. I wish Samus Reyes could have been a part of it, but hopefully Logan Thomas can bring back all of the information and insight that he got from that tight end university and brings it to Samus Reyes and John Bates as well. But that's really dope that Logan Thomas is recognized as a good enough tight end. He honestly should have made the Pro Bowl over Evan Engram last year. But it's dope that Logan Thomas is recognized as a fellow peer to like George Kittle, Travis Kelce, and Greg Olsen. Like, they recognized him as one of the good tight ends in the NFL. That's dope to hear. And then there's a few lists that we have some problems with over here. From Washington Football Team Nation, from Burgundy and Gold Nation, we have a few problems. First of all, there's this one list with the top 10 players in the NFC East. They have Zach Martin number one, Fletcher Cox number two, Jason Kelce number three, Amari Cooper number four, Chase Young number five, then Dak Prescott number six, Brandon Scherff number seven, Tyron Smith number eight, Lane Johnson number nine, and then Blake Martinez is the only Giants player coming in at number 10 over James Bradberry and all these other guys, over Leonard Williams. It's pretty funny. But, you know, even as a Washington football team fan who has two players on here, I'm still upset. But it's whatever, man. These people make these lists. What can you do? Also, Pro Football Focus came out with their top 50 players in the NFL. We had none. Not even one. No Chase Young, no Terry McLaurin, no Jonathan Allen, no Daron Payne, no Logan Thomas, no William Jackson. But it's cool though. By the time they do this list next year, we'll probably have like five guys up there. No lie, for real. At least two. I mean, no Brandon Scherff. Come on now. And lastly, NFL Network did an all under 25 team, and the only player to make the list was Chase Young. Again, this list is going to be filled with Washington football team players this time next season. Once they've actually gone on the field and proven it, once we start to actually win games in a respectable way, now that we finally have at least, at the very least, average quarterback play, guys like Terry McLaurin should be able to show what they could do. Our defense is going to be even more complete. So guys like Chase Young, Daron Payne, Jonathan Allen, potentially Jamin Davis will all be able, maybe even Benjamin St. Juice can step up in a big way. I definitely feel like we're going to have more on all three of these lists this time next year than we had this year. But yeah, man, that's the end of this video. Please get in the comment section and let me know how you feel about everything discussed in this video. The list, all of the new hires, Logan Thomas being invited to the tight end university camp, everything. And also, please like this video if you liked it, if you learned anything. I'm pretty sure you learned something, so you gotta leave a like before you dip up out of here. And as always, man, I really appreciate all of the support, man. Big shouts out to everybody that donates to the channel. Big shouts out to all of my sponsors, especially my Pro Bowl sponsors whose name you see scrolling on the screen right now. A special shouts out to my one All-Pro sponsor, Jaden. And I really appreciate just all of y'all in general for being patient with me. I have been able to keep my live streams up, but we're getting a lot of things out of the way now as far as the yard goes and everything around the house. So hopefully I'll be a little bit less busy going to these next couple of weeks. I'm really trying to get these film sessions out to y'all before the training camp starts. So stay tuned for all of that. Again, stay patient with everything, please. And of course, subscribe to the channel, man. Like I said in the intro video, make sure you subscribe, hit the bell next to the subscription button so you get a notification immediately and every time I release videos and start up live streams. And as always, man, I really appreciate all of the support. I'll catch y'all later. I'm out.